Well, the special rapporteur is appointed by the Human Rights Council, and he or she must report periodically to the Human Rights Council and the General Assembly of the United Nations about the situation of independence of judges and lawyers in the world, following specific cases or situations that he or she may have received, and of course, eventually making special visits after the invitation that may have been received to countries, so to prepare as well reports to be presented to the Human Rights Council. All these reports are not part of the specific treaty, or they are not binding as what could be a decision by an international court, but are key information so that the Human Rights Council or the General Assembly may take specific decisions oriented to guarantee and protect independence of judges and lawyers. One of the ingredients of an independent justice is the access of the public to lawyers. Without access to a legal service, there will be difficult access to the judicial system. So it is the counterpart of judicial independence is the access to lawyers in a context in which in several parts of the world, besides attacks that are being received by judges or prosecutors, lawyers are being threatened, attacked, and persecuted, which eliminates the possibility of access to justice. So one of the key components is that this is a right that should be preserved. There are basic principles adopted in the UN in 1990 regarding access to lawyers, which protects not only lawyers as an individual, but lawyers associations in Article 24 or those basic principles as a major component. This right is being threatened in several parts of the world. It's a question that doesn't refer or concern to a private job or private activity, but it has to do with basic rights, and there is a duty of the state to protect access from the public to a legal service to lawyers. So that's a question that has to do with international law at the end of the day. Well, there are international standards that should be closely monitored by international bodies, no? Like the Human Rights Council, for instance, that are part of the international rules that all states should follow. But at the same time, the world community should follow that there are internal guarantees so that access to justice when lawyers are being threatened or attacked, access to media when they are being threatened or attacked, and of course, the way through which the public can have access to justice without a lawyer is very, 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 very difficult. So I think the international organizations can play a crucial role, United Nations, and as well, the key and specific important activity placed by CCBE, for instance, are one of the most relevant associations of lawyers in the world, which follows in the case of the CCBE, not only the situation of lawyers in Europe, but from several parts of the world. As special rapporteur on independence of justice and lawyers, I should express my deep appreciation for the important information and important role being played by organizations like CCBE, as is being played by many other lawyers associations in the world. Without those lawyers associations, we should be whose independence should be fully guaranteed, it will be much more difficult to protect the independence of judges of lawyers in the world. Basic principles of 1990 are very relevant, but unfortunately they are not an international treaty. What I have followed closely as a special rapporteur is the steps being taken in Europe and in the Council of Europe to prepare an international instrument, which I hope would be an international treaty establishing the rights of lawyers, which eventually could be open to countries which are not members of the Council of Europe. That could be a major step forward for the guaranteeing the rights of lawyers and for lawyers associations. So as a special rapporteur has been invited as an observer in this process, I, before leaving this post at the end of this year, I will look very strongly that they really continue this process, and at the end of the day, they get an agreement to prepare an international treaty open to countries outside of the Council of Europe. That will be a major step forward for the rule of law in the world.